We could make it go dangerously fast, but I don't think either of us has the guts to like plow 45 miles an hour in a go-kart that's driving itself. So we generally have it go like 2 miles an hour. I'm Izzy, I'm 17 years old, and I somehow created an autonomous go-kart using AWS Deep Racer. My first project was a go-kart, a little wood one. I was like four. My sister and my dad were working on this go-kart, and I'm like, okay, that's cool.
Hi, I'm Todd. I'm the dad.
I wanted to make cool things and have them. And my dad actually had skills with it. For a long time, he did most of the work because I was really little.
We started small with making a robot lizard.
Then it was like the robotics dragon wings for Halloween. Then it was a giant cardboard T-Rex costume. It was insane. Then the go-kart started. It was actually my dad who suggested that we make it autonomous. And I was like, I agreed to it. And I'm like, how hard could it possibly be? That was a year and a half ago. Once we decided to make it autonomous, I started coming up with ideas of how that would work. And then my dad's like, oh yeah, there's this thing called the Deep Racer. It's an AWS's autonomous RC car that we pretty much Frankensteined. We physically disconnected it from its traditional servos, hooked it up to bigger servos to physically control the go-kart. The deep lens is the one sensor we use for the Deep Racer. It's pretty much the eyes of the go-kart. The deep lens is taking in visual footage of the track. It doesn't connect to the internet. It doesn't do any processing anywhere else. And then through the magic of machine learning, it turns that into a servo movement to move forward and to turn. Models are trained in the cloud with SageMaker, RoboMaker. SageMaker, I think of it like the brain. You know, it does all the processing, the reasoning. RoboMaker is the senses. For the Deep Racer, it's the eyes. And all the processing is in the cloud. And then we created a model of the environment we want the go-kart to be able to drive around in.
And that was used over the couple hundred hours to train the model that then Izzy deployed onto the Red Rover, and now it drives on the elementary school track down the street.
I'm about to test the go-kart and check the model I've been working on that is more realistic and matches the go-kart in size. I guess what pushed me, in the beginning was one, go-karts are cool. Two, I just wanted to see if I could. When I encounter a problem, I refuse to let it beat me. I kind of see this go-kart as a troublesome child. I'm like, we are gonna work through this and it's gonna be great and you're gonna be great. And I can't imagine backing down.